opened their program with a fanfare. This was a variation from St. Andrew's Variations by Alan Ferner. The composer wrote about the piece. The title of the St. Andrew's Variations has no significance apart from the fact it was written by a Scotsman to be played in St. Andrew's Hall. Now, at this stage, the band would like to thank Third Carrick Fergus Youth Band for, in good spirit of banding, allowing Lee Forsyth to come in on flugel due to a family funeral involving three of the first Old Boys players. Also, we'd like to thank our own Shane Hart for stepping up to the principal soprano cornet seat for this contest. Shane has been our apprentice soprano player for about 4 weeks now, so good luck to him today. Xylophone solo. Connor Chambers, our soloist today, with Mark Bingham's arrangement of the George Botsford Classic. The Black and White Rag was written in 1908, and first known recording of this piece was by Albert Benzier on wax cylinder, and was made famous in the 1950s by Winifred Atwell and her honky-tonk piano. This was also adopted as the theme tune for the popular TV snooker show then, entitled Hot Black. Here is the Black and White Rag.
One, two, three.
entertainment. Let's thank again Amy Edwards, Caitlin Harvey, Victoria Lloyd, and Joyce Highlands. Well done. And through the final item of five, Dr. Jacqueline Bingham and the First Rovers Youth Band. To finish the programme, the children sung great music by Eric Ball, and you probably have heard this morning. This march you're about here was written in 1937 and first performed at the Star Lake Salvation Army Music Camp, Bloomingdale in New Jersey. It was Eric Ball's first visit to the camp, and he wrote it for that occasion. Here is the march, Star Lake.